This will be a demonstration for how to trigger external equipment every 15 beats. So right now this is a tutorial, we'll use some pre-recorded data. You can use acknowledge in playback mode. So let's go ahead and open a file for playback. The sample data is stored in this location, program data, biopack. So we'll choose the ECG file over here. This is just lead to ECG data. And now we want to send a trigger, TTL pulse, every 15 beats based on the ECG, on the heart rate data. This menu here, the playback menu, would ordinarily be your MP150 or MP36R menu. But right now it says playback since we're just playing back the data. We'll come over here and set up calculation channels. So our analog channel is the ECG. And the calculation channels will first of all include a rate calculation channel. And we want to record the number of peaks. We can use one of the presets here, heart rate from human ECG. We can make adjustments, especially for these parameters here, the windowing units, depending on whether the person has a low or high resting heart rate, if they're exercising or not. We don't need any marker events. So this calculation channel will output the rate expressed as a continuous counter for the number of peaks. That is, it will count the number of heartbeats. Okay, then we add one more channel, and this channel will be an expression. So we want to take this calculation channel that we just made. So we want to calculate the modulus of this counter of beats and the number of 16. So this means when we go through the ECG data, we have essentially a peak at 15, and then it will go back down to zero, and then a peak at 15, and so forth. You will see this when the data are being recorded. We'll just call this, it doesn't matter what unit we use here, so let's click OK. And finally, we need one more channel. And this channel is going to turn on and off digital channels depending on the level of the expression calculation. So let's just choose this one over here. Okay, so whenever the data fall between 14 and 15, we'll go ahead and send out the pulse on one of the digital channels. So let's say it's digital channel 0. Okay, let's fire it up, and we'll change the scale to about 30 seconds, and let's auto-scale the waveforms, auto-scale them again. So we can see here the second channel is the counter of the peaks. So every time we have a new QRS complex, this adds one to the number here. So this channel, if we look at it over here, if we look at the value, the value box, so 13, 14, 15, 16, so this counter keeps going up. And the expression channel is giving us a counter that peaks at 15, comes back down to 0, peaks at 15, because this is the modulus operator. Let's auto-scale the waveforms. And then on the bottom, we have the control channel, which will turn on and off digital channels depending on the value of this calculation channel here with the expression. Right now, we did not set it up correctly because it's actually not sending out any pulses. So let's see what was done wrong. Let's stop for a second, come back to the setup here. Okay, now the source has to be set to the expression channel. By default, it goes to the very first channel. Now it's set to the expression channel, and we can begin again, override the data. Okay, and soon we'll see the results. So we can again change the scale a bit over here. And now we are about to reach 15, and there is our pulse, which is actually seen on digital channel zero. And there are several ways in which you can access this pulse, and you can take it to external equipment. You can take it from this UIM-100C module directly from the back of the module using the screw terminals. You can actually plug in there into the screw terminals and send that pulse to other to external equipment. This will be not a very safe way of doing things because you break an optical isolation between our system and the other equipment. You could also use the STP-100C module, which would be the preferred way. The STP-100C module has these relay drives on the front. There are four of these relay drives, so you could actually control several pieces of equipment. Let's pause this acquisition for a second. And here you can see the STP-100C. And right on the front of the STP-100C are these relay drives, and they map to digital channels 0, 1, 2, and 3. So all you have to do is connect, this is a BNC connection at the end, so all we have to do is plug into the BNC connector and take the signal output to the external device you wish to control based on this beat counter.